நீயில்லாத நாளல்ல நாளாகுமா நீயில்லாத வாழ்வல்ல வாழ்வாகுமா
Book of John chapter 6 verse 12 When they had all had enough to eat he said to his disciples Gather the pieces that are left over let nothing be wasted If so, then every blessing from the Lord is like a miracle. Those leftovers are blessings from God. And He says that it should not go to waste. Gather the pieces that are left over. Children of God listening to this, you must have savings for it is a blessing unto you. And at the same time, you should also not live just to save and store up from whatever we earn by the grace of God. Apart from the offerings, our everyday expenses, and what we give to God, we have to save the remaining. Saving is not inappropriate. In 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 14, Paul says, After all, children should not have to save up for their parents, but parents for their children. Therefore, saving money is not wrong. Moreover, if you do not run your family by saving in such way, then that believer is worse than an unbeliever. In 1 Timothy 5:8, we see anyone who does not provide for their household. Therefore, by not spending lavishly what God has given, you must be thrift mindful in your job and stay faithful. And from the remains, save a little for yourself. Because saving is not improper. Furthermore, it is no wrong in utilizing what the Lord has given. That is because our God says, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17, But to put thy hope in God who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. Therefore, it is no wrong in spending happily what is given by the Lord. For he is the Lord who bestows such blessings. But one thing we should be aware of, that these worldly blessings must not spoil our spiritual blessings. Dear children of God, today many of you might be worried that I don't have that, he has this much, the house has so much, they have got a car, they have got a bike, they bought a house, they built a house. Saying all this, you might be with many worries of different kinds. To you, the Lord says, let the worldly blessings not harm your spiritual blessings. It should not be an obstacle for us to get near God. For it is very important we must always be cautious in this case. Any of this earthly wealth should never stand in the way to spiritual abundance, such as our holiness and closeness to our Savior. For it is God's will for us to live up to those things. Today the Lord says, Do not worry, for He will fulfill every need of yours perfectly at the right time. The Lord will not fail you. Hallelujah. God bless you.